Welcome back to the Composer Mindset. This is Daniel. I'm going to be starting a new composition. I have no idea what I'm going to be writing. No idea. I'm just going to get started. Hopefully it'll be fun. I guess that's really my only goal. Once again, I'm a composer. I have written for film, TV, games, and lots of other things. I have over 20 years experience in the field. And I'm doing this just for funsies. So let's see what I come up with. Just make sure that... All right, I think we're good to go. All right, the old blank session. Don't know what I'm going to do yet, but let's find out. It's been a while since I've worked on this template. It's just a basic orchestral template. I don't know. Let's start with tuba. Maybe mess around a little bit. My first melody that came out of my fingers. I guess I'm just sketching here. Today I'm going to do more writing and less talking. sort of studying that as it played back. It's not quite pentatonic. I mean, it's definitely this modal, this Aeolian mode, natural minor thing, but almost has a minor pentatonic-ness to it. I wonder if I should roll with that a little bit more. No, no, we'll see. We'll see. It is super low. I wonder if I just want to put double it in horn, maybe. Second. Let's see. Start harmonizing. Trombone is not the right instrument for that. It's just a little too brassy sounding, too bright. It's just the tubular shape of the, well, it's just the shape of the instrument makes it more bright. I think maybe that harmonization is probably best in the low horns.
Thank you.
big wide jumps there, but kind of functions as an escape tone. Better. Like voice overlapping there that maybe could be a little smoother. Let's get that. Fifth, they jump to the fifth. Thank you. Trying to decide if this upper horn part sounds like one voice or two. This big jump down here makes it sound like the big jump down to that lower register makes it sound like a different part, and this feels kind of orphaned up here. For now, I know I have a sort of overlapping part there, but maybe it's fine. Oh no. To reload my choir. Apologies. It'll take but a moment. I just want to hear how choir might sound in there. All right, that'll just load in, right? Load. Any second now, choir, you're up. What's going on? Technical problems. Come on now. There. Switching screens, switching computers. All right, so we got something super dark, brooding. Space between the phrases. Shrink this down a bit here. Trying to find like that syllable or those syllables. Apostolus. Sloppy. Muri Suri? Maybe a different voicing. Nothing there. The higher register yet for the voices. Yuck, pretty unbalanced. All right, root position. Fine, fine. fine. And let's have that upper voice in horn two. Let's put that in the choir too. Always a nice sound having the choir with low brass. Function not supported in current window. Okay. Thanks, Logic. I think the pedaling is there too. Needs to be touched up a little bit, and I want to just revisit this brass here with the releases on some of these chords that are held. Make it a little bit more, give a little more room to the choir that's coming in and out. Feels kind of clunky just holding on to that A minor chord. Like, I want to hear a pickup into measure 10 from the brass and the choir. Let me get that sorted here. I guess I was just looking at that. Because we're getting sort of a feeling of forward movement, even though it's plodding along, but there is some movement developing. Let's see how we're going to get into that. Experiment. There's that pentatonic. Okay, it's nice. And let's get those. Let's continue with the pickup beats. Put that in the choir too. Those parallel fourths at the end of measure 10. And then with the overlapping voices into 11, I wonder if I can do better. I mean, I like the melody, but maybe we need to adjust. I'll come back to that. Let me get my pickups. It was a mistake. I copied it into the wrong spot, but I like the mistake. The parallel fourth sound good, and it's kind of unavoidable. Well, it's always avoidable. It sort of fits with the mode. I just wonder if I should. Let's see, then we're going to an octave there. I don't think that's going to be better. Same thing. Those choir parts doing the same thing as the brass. That was the lower one. Sure, and then this was the upper part. And then I gotta remove the pedal. Stop it. Logic, do what you're told. I'll put syllables in, just sort of roughing things out here. And I think things are overlapping too much in terms of the MIDI events. So. Feels like a letdown, harmonically speaking. And then you go get in your head about, okay, well, should I follow the traditional rules a little bit more, or do I just go with what I've got? Maybe I'll just go with what I've got. And then sometimes those come back and bite you later. It's a good start. I'm gonna work with it. If I have to fiddle with some of the voice leading, then I will. But I'm gonna just leave it like that to start. One more time. Hearing timpani in here. How do I get it to roll? Roll for me, baby. Programmed better. I like those. That's nice. This is a very severe sounding composition all of a sudden. Maybe I just should have the swell. That back, mute it. Get that timing a little nicer. Enthusiastic, huh? See, a little early too, just a hair. Okay, it's workable. Still, it's still maybe a little too enthusiastic. All right. All right. So then we'd go to just regular. There. Just bumping notes all over the place here. See what I'm trying to harmonize here. D good? Sure, I think D works. Let's track the pickup notes with the timpani. It's going to sound too loud. Sort of implying D, B minor there, sure. Mm. So clearly I'm establishing parallel chord movements as part of the palette. Picture like some grumpy old king sitting on a throne having a very bad day. Very bad day for that king. We need a little, I don't know if I want to try to add a little bit more color to this. It's so super dark. It's so dark. Maybe just something that's a tiny bit more cheery. Maybe we need to just go with the dark. See, the harp is adding just couple percentage points of color in there. So is the timpani. I'll go fix that in a second. Yikes. Shouldn't be doing the timpani here. It should be doing. Yeah, it should be doubling one of these parts. Doubling the other. just give the choir something better to sing than, color these tracks better. All right. Second, while I get some syllables here. I don't know what they're gonna say. Legato. You know what? Damn it. Selected the wrong thing. Force legato. Keep. Didn't really do a good job there. Jump up to that octave like that? Is that how my other part was? Did I do that? No. I think I lost something. What? Something's not right. See the harp. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah. ED. Oh, something got lost. Oh, I see. That's the part there, and this one goes. It was a little tedious working on choir. I'll just put some changes in the syllables they're singing. I'm going to listen back. Just having it so anytime there's a new note, there's a new syllable, and then I just go in and tweak it so it sounds decent. I mean, they're not really singing any lyrics per se. All right, I'll work with that for now. The harp kind of muddies things. It's already so dark in the low, low register of so many of those instruments. Instruments, the articulation is just the tiniest bit slow. It's like taking a bit for them to speak. I might have to nudge those around a little bit. I'm going to grab this just as an experiment and try just some low pits. Staccato strings. I'm not sure if it's really going to add a lot to the texture or just something minimal. Dark. I almost feel like maybe we could get away with just at this very last phrase, another voice. Maybe low trumpet. Not doing much. Just something quiet and. Same time. Whoops. Yeah, there's that those parallels there. Let's get rid of that. There's an answer. I really don't want the trumpet doing a lot. What we got? Yeah, what we got? Feels really heavy sitting on that B. And you know what? I think we need to have the ba-ba-ba rhythm in the trumpet too. You could just grab, get that in there. Where'd you go, trumpet? I think my mod wheel is starting to die. Create note. Create. There we go. And where's the articulation? What? Oh. They're eighth notes. Hoping the trumpet would brighten things up a little bit. Maybe it's just gotta be solemn. That upper trumpet there is a little bit, tiny bit unsupported there, but sure, I really want to die. Boy, that chord is bottom heavy. Also getting a bit tired. I'm going to be going to bed in a minute here, but let me listen back to my extremely solemn, serious sounding piece here. Stop. Let me see if one thing, maybe we just need more nobility. Just more nobility. He's still a proud king, even though he's a sad king. I don't know. Yes, I do. Hang on. Before I commit to that. Oh, I know what I'm looking at. Hold on. Yeah, just checking my voice leading. In the wrong measure. From 17 to the end is a little bit unbalanced. What we've got with doubling the fifth. It's nice. Very, very solemn, very serious. Okay. I'll leave it there for now. I'm getting pretty tired. It's late for me. I'm going to come back to this as soon as I can and continue. I'm always surprised when I just sit down and write Never know what's going to happen. I didn't have any particular thing in mind, just going for it. So we'll see what happens with this. Maybe it's just going to be such a serious, serious, serious composition. I don't know. Maybe we can find a way to perk things up. Who knows? Stay tuned. Until next time, I'm Daniel with the Composer Mindset. Don't forget to like and subscribe and share with all your friends.